The spirit in Hong Kong has always been about food. It doesn't matter who you are, where you are, how rich or poor you are. It's all about the taste of the food, and it's all about the quality of the food. And I think every chef has their own story.
我初初咧就係對呢個行業係認識嘅，咁啊零神咧針啊落嚟跟啲師傅一路學。我就整咗40幾年咯，去到邊度都係有蛋撻做嘅。
I think the street food represent how we love food, but also this kind of store represent what Hong Kong people is like. They're just really hardworking.
要捱落去，要用心嚟做，唔用心做唔到命。成唔成功係一回事啊，總之係自己盡咗力就算。
啲客人中意食我啲嘢，做得開心，有時咧攰都值大嘅。你好嘛？你好。
好耐冇見。
好耐冇見啊，大家。This
shop is a very special place for me because this is not just a place for making money. It's really a place for myself, for my childhood, and for my family and all the friends in the town.
There's a phrase I go back to quite often in Hong Kong. It's called 人情味. I think this is like almost the flavor of the human connection.
點啊？嗰個感覺。
Hong
Kong street food is vibrant, it's delicious, it's authentic, and for me, it's a flavor of memories. It reminds me of who I used to be.
These people, these dishes inspire me in my kitchen. I want to deliver that same feeling to my guests.
As a chef, it is perhaps our duty and responsibility to make sure that this is a memory and a flavor that will always be here as a part of Hong Kong.
I worked overseas for many years. Coming back recently to Hong Kong has reignited my love for the city, and I think has reminded me why I first wanted to become a chef. I grew up in Sam Shui Po, and there was, and still is, a strong community spirit. Everything revolved around family, community, and food.
我乜嘢都識。I
was born in Central Po as well, just 5 minutes walk from the shop. Our Kung Wo has a very long history, over 100 years in Hong Kong. In 1997, my father bought over the whole business. He promised his friends so he will run in the same way as it was. It's very hard to handle most of the work, but every time when we meet people, they say they love our food, they love our tofu. So I think we always try our best not to give up.
Well, you know, I'm a fine dining chef, but my passion for food and cooking comes from the streets of Hong Kong. My earliest memories of Hong Kong was when I was 10 and younger. That's when I moved to Canada. I still remember the days where my mom and dad and I, late at night, would go out to go street food hopping and just look for different delicious foods. There's a saying in Cantonese called So Gai. It literally translates to sweeping the streets. How we go through the whole entire street and you go to each shop and you don't necessarily have a full meal, but you only have like a bit of everything. And this has always been a tradition in Hong Kong.
From the start of the street, you can keep sweeping, keep So Gai. When you don't want a lunch, don't want a dinner, you want something in the middle, you're hungry, you can try a bit of different things. That's the vibe of the city. We offer a bit of everything.
Hong Kong is a fast-paced city. People just want to like grab something. If you talk about street food, we have like so many choices. Fishball, siu mai, egg waffle, and you can holding like a few bags of food and then like walking around and enjoying eating.
可唔可以俾一個媽咪食啊？ 好食啊！
Later in the evening, then I'll go thank you tofu, the skewers, octopus.
Curry fish balls, beef offals, a lot of dishes that only exist in Hong Kong.
Mmm, it's so good.
When you feel thirsty, you can go back to other bubble tea or sugar cane juice or coconut juice, and you can continue like a cycle. I can So Gai every day if I don't need to work.
For For me, the perfect so gai would be to start with beef offals because I just love it. And then you have a skewer of the fish ball in curry sauce. And I probably finish with stinky tofu. That would be my perfect scenario. Hey guys, have a good night, huh? Cheers. Bye bye. Thank you. Bye bye. Hello. Make sure you clean up everything before you go, yeah? Huh? See you tomorrow. So late at night in Hong Kong, the streets come alive, and there's really nothing quite like it. So after service, that's when I love to go street food hunting.
Hong Kong is a city of night owls, but it's also a city for early risers. People are out on the street very early in the morning, grabbing breakfast or a bite to eat before work. So for me, my ideal so gai will start with breakfast, followed by some of my favorite snacks and dessert from my childhood.
Hey, 老闆.
Hello.
Hello,
hello. Hello.
So Soike is a restaurant not far from mine, and it's a family-run restaurant. The dad is the chef, and then the son is like the disciple. And for me, it's one of the best in Hong Kong for beef offals.
You are my 最中意食嘅牛雜同牛腩嚟嘅，真係因為我仲好記得我第一次喺度食咧。我諗起碼都有11年前啦。
你俾我鬧過啊？唔講呢啲，唔講呢啲。我好記得喺呢度食一個你哋個牛磅啊！我真係成世係唯一一間係好食，因為其他全部都唔好食嘅，鞋濕曬，好似粉嘅咁啊！我真係其實我想問你好耐，我諗唔夠膽問。
想問我好耐，你喺出邊唔食？
食啲牛蒡唔好食嘅牛蒡啊，喺廚房嘅。哦，就係咁。佢冰到佢啊，入邊起曬沙食落去，一粒粒一粒。係咯。咁好食。咁你呢啲全部都新鮮嘅，牛腩、牛雜，咩嘢都新鮮嘅。全部新鮮。哇！今日做嘅嘢就聽日買。They
take fresh beef offals, a lot of work to clean it, to have the skills to cook it, and to also be consistent about the taste and the flavor and the texture.
個老豆傳落嚟係咁樣做法，我話依照佢咁樣做法。咁水記就係你爹哋做出嚟嘅。我老豆做出嚟。即係我老豆走嗰陣時，我已經唔想做大文豪。
但
係
你而家又可以上咗去。
你話你可以咁講，亦都可以。唉，咁啊，你冇計嘅。即係成唔成功係一回事啊。
總之啊，自己盡咗力就算。西哥，不如我哋食啲嘢咯。
好啊，食啲嘢先啊。啊，有冇留？有冇啲特別啲嘅？
我幫你安排啊。
唔該曬，唔該曬。好，老闆，我坐低先。好。唔該，要個黐飯。好啊，靚女，你認唔認得我先？
Every time if I go past Yau Ma Tei, I'll go to Tongda. Tongda is a store that very close to where I study high school.
So what I'm eating here is called chi fan in Cantonese. And this is outside sticky rice. Inside is like a Chinese donut. In the middle, there's some pork floss, there's some preserved daikon choy po. I guess it gives you a lot of energy. It has texture. It is very warming. So this is a perfect Hong Kong breakfast grab and go.
Offal eating, intestines and parts of the animals are very popular in Hong Kong. Back in the days, the best parts of the animal always goes to the emperor, the kings. The rest of the parts of the animal all goes to the civilians, the workers. It was a source of protein, which they needed in the diet. And then quickly they find out, not only is it edible, but it's actually quite delicious.
即係我 keep 住40-50年嗰啲口味咧，好多熟客翻嚟咧，移咗民啊。
搬咗去第二度啦，跟住翻嚟咧仍然係認同翻，因為其實我個責任係 keep 住個口味啫嘛，係根據呢個人嘅食慾啊。
All of a sudden, offal eating is a very common thing, especially in Hong Kong. You know, when my friends come to Hong Kong, depending on how open they are, I absolutely bring them to have offals.
你好啊，嗱呢碗咧就係沙瓜河，哇，仲有嚟緊啊！呢碗就牛雜河，啊呢碗就係脆骨爽冷麵。唔該曬，唔該曬。嗯。
It's so good. Look at it. The inside of it is filled with the spices, the lo sui from the broth. And it's all kind of like trapped. The star anise, the five spice, clove, maybe a little bit of cinnamon. It's so delicious.
There are certain parts of the animal that they only receive a small amount of it every day. If they have 10 portions of this, they only allow you to order one bowl of this particular part. It's very obvious it's not about selling 100 bowls more to make more money. It's about receiving 100 new guests and see the smiles on their face to know that they've enjoyed something, a part of the animal that you cannot get anywhere else in Hong Kong because it's basically allocated to them.
過嚟呢度每一次過嚟呢度，我都見到你，你一定喺度。係啊，六點幾翻嚟㗎啦，同啲伙計同老豆一齊洗牛雜啊，開牛腩啊，好啦。哇！咁你由細到跟住你爹哋跟到而家？以前讀書年代就暑期工，係咁係呢幾年翻嚟幫下佢咯。我老豆嘅意願就係希望保育翻香港所有嘅大排檔，即係香港嘅特色嚟㗎嘛。係。
I have a lot of respect for these street vendors setting up every day and breaking it down on the slope of the street, extremely hot, is hard work. I think the secret to their success is their perseverance of sourcing the best ingredients, serving the best food they possibly can. And I think for that reason, after the hard work, for them, it's still something that they truly enjoy.
Wow, if this is the beginning of our Soul Guy journey, we're on to a very good start.
Hey, hello!
Hey, hello. Hey, hello. Hey, hello. Hey, hello. Hey, hello.
Hey, hello. Hey,
hello. Hey, hello. Hey, hello. Hey, hello. Hey, hello.
Hey, hello.
Hey, hello. Hey, hello.
Hey, hello. Hey, hello.
Hey, hello.
有冇同阿Jojo聯絡啊？有，而家都幾好啊！幾好啊！幾好，OK啊！幾開心。Tone
Dad is owned by one of my best friend Jojo's parents.
阿陳咧，佢啊同班同學嚟嘅，放學啊嚟呢度食嘢，咁啊一齊玩啊咁咯。Every
time when we walk past, we will either order the the fish ball or we will sit down because they have 碗仔翅, which is like a local version or fake version of shark fin soup. For lunchtime, you can have 油炸麵。油炸麵 You know when you fry the pork lard?
油炸麵咧根本上咧就係好街坊小食嚟嘅。以前咧我哋中國人咧好中意食豬油噶嘛，咁啊攞啲豬油渣就擺落啲面度，啲上海面度。咁啊後期我哋咧就覺得脆豬油渣好食嘅，咁啊而家炸每日炸，所以而家我哋啲油渣就係脆嘅。所以我哋個餐牌咧寫明咧就係懷舊脆油炸麵。
你都掛住你哋個，梗係要啦，同埋眼燒埋，係咪？係啊係啊，誒係啦，掛住你個，梗係要啦，你真係啊！嚟，喂，試下先啦，好味啊，最緊要試下粒先，試下先啦，好味，嗯，即係你次次經過都同我食魚蛋嘅喎，係啦，影下嗰個感覺，翻返嚟。
得唔得？有冇變到啊？有冇變到？
真係好好味，梗係要啦！喺嗰個地鐵人就話：，誒，聞到魚蛋味，即刻上去食魚蛋。嗰個感覺好，即係呢啲小食就好受歡迎嘅。同埋我哋呢一區咧，多嗰啲學生啦，所以即係佢哋啲學生好中意食呢啲類似小食嘅嘢。
讀書嚟食，
食到有咗結咗婚啦，拖住佢啲細路仔嚟食魚蛋。
問我哋你厭唔厭得我啊？咁咯。
I left Hong Kong for 14 years, and then now I'm back to Hong Kong, and Jojo is away. So now going to their store, they feel like
they are meeting their daughter. So I think that also makes them feel really warming. And it's great to see them like that.
我哋好團結，問佢啲嘢㗎，譬如話我哋啲嘢做得好唔好啊，嗰啲執業點樣教啊咁樣咯，佢好肯教，教我哋㗎。我哋一陣你好開心咯。係啊，好開心，我哋見到好開心㗎。你成日食飯，我一遲啲電話嚟。去我嗰度食飯。好啊。好啦。你食嘢，食嘢，探下安田最緊要，知唔知安田掛住你啊？唉，
唔好，我食飯。
記得電話嚟啦。好啦，同埋都同我提，拜拜。
You can have fishball everywhere in Hong Kong now. I like mine really spicy. I love it when you can still taste the fish, but then it's got enough flour that has a bit of a chew. And this one has all of that. I think spiciness brings a sense of excitement in many of these street foods because it's always meant to be exciting. We call it joyusik. Joyusik meaning that you always want the second one and the third one and the fourth one. It's like a good bag of chips. You want to have a lot. And street food is always the same.
Actually, my grandpa started in the business of Hong Kong street food since 1960s. My dad decided to get a permanent place, which is this shop here, in 1997. In 2019, my dad is passed away. I operate like a Japanese restaurant in Australia with my brother. And then we just sold everything, come back to Hong Kong, and we decided we want to continue my dad's legacy. This is still my family business. I got my cousin here, my uncle, my brother, my mom. Yeah, this is Hong Kong spirit.
Hong Kong street food is, for me, it's a flavor of memories. You have a lot of dishes and skewers that truly only belongs here in Hong Kong. So every time you see it, every time you taste it, it reminds me of who I used to be. Where did Victoria go? I can't see Victoria.
Here!
Oh, there you are. These are pictures that I haven't seen forever. This is me when I was, I think, 6 years old. Growing up, every Friday, we'd go to this street. There would always be a lot of these push carts around, and each cart was selling different things. So my mother would give me like $10 Hong Kong, and it would be there for 2 hours, eating so many things. That was my most joyful thing growing up, is to take the small amount of money and so gai, basically.
Victoria, and what is this? Do you want to eat that?
Gai Daan Jai!
You want to go get some Gai Daan Jai later?
Yes!
When I was a child, this shop is a very special place for me because when I finished my primary school, I always came over to Kong Wo and say hello to all the friends, uncle and aunties here.
Hi, Abba, good morning.
Tofu
pudding, the tofu fat, that's something I really like to have after school, putting the natural cane sugar on top so it melts slowly on top of the tofu pudding. And then you could enjoy all the sugar like melting on your tongue. It's a very special experience.
我陣間11點鐘個女落嚟啊嘛，俾一碗我得。我12歲咧開始就跟我爸爸做大排檔啦。咁我細細個亦都好有興趣做呢個飲食行業嘅。我初初咧就係對呢個行業係唔識嘅，咁啊。 邊做邊學啦，咁啊夜晚凌晨咧就咁啊落嚟跟啲師傅一路學整靚嘅豆腐咧，就首先要有靚嘅黃豆啦，傳統嘅石磨啦，跟住就要講師傅啦，咁咧就變到啲顧客佢食落有個口感，咁就佢咪長期嚟幫襯啦。
7 years ago, the kitchen was quite old and it was a big project for us to renovate the shop. All the friends and the neighbors, they were all worried whether we could continue to enjoy the tofu. I was working in finance at that time. I told my father, I want to quit my job and I want to come back and help you. His first reaction is, are you kidding me?
我都覺得有啲出奇啊。 咁佢始終都係大學生，就冇諗到佢跟我做呢一個行業。不過其實都冇乜所謂嘅，最緊要做得開心就得啦。
And then after we finish the renovation, I see increasing number of people coming to visit us. And then I make the decision to open one more next door. I really want to present Gong Wo in a new way, so you can have a try of the new and the old, and lots of young people loved it.
Hello,
hello, hello, hello,
hello, hello,
hello,
hello,
hello,
hello,
I think a lot of these stalls have been passed down from generations to generations. It's so nice to see that a lot of people are still carrying it on. A good example would be Fei Zai.
十幾年前嗰時候，我幫我媽手，自己開始覺得大個啦，咪出嚟呢度試下做咯。可唔可以加辣甜醬啊？要，乜都要。哦，可唔可以要兩寸兩寸啊？可以可以。你買得最多係咩啊？魷魚啊，生腸啊嗰啲咯。我舅父咧，每一次美國翻嚟香港都一定要嚟呢度。啊哈。OK嘛，我哋呢啲食。好，唔該曬。
Bye. So this here is called Cheung Fan. Believe it or not, it's a part of the fallopian tube of pork. I know it sounds very crazy, but it's delicious. It's crunchy, it's tender. I don't eat fallopian tubes every day, but when I do, I come here.
我喺冇開工，朝頭早就去街市啊買啊，買曬啲材料啊，咪攞翻嚟鋪頭度整咯。我都有十一款嘢，每一日我哋賣到千零串嘅嘢咯。
This squid is purposely dyed orange. Many people wonder why it's orange. It's just a very attractive color compared to the brown color food. That was a belief since decades ago. And so it's always been the tradition.
老水嘢就係有焦燒啊、白角啊、果皮啊嗰類嘢咯，煲四五個鐘到咯，先會出咗啲味道出嚟咯。唔係一定話出唔出名，最緊要好食。
The flavor is always this yellow mustard and this sweet Chinese miso sauce. And a lot of places do it, but for me, this is one of the best in Hong Kong that does it in the most flavorful and tender way.
Mmm, so good,
so good.
我覺得整翻以前我哋細細個咁口味，即係唔會變。啲客人中意食我啲嘢，做開心，有時咧攰都值得嘅。
第一間鋪到佐敦嗰度，好似沙士第二年嗰年，到佐敦嗰間咧做域王，覺得鋪租貴啊，後尾我就執走，停咗8年。Hello，Hello，方太啊，你好，我第一次嚟啊，嗯嗯，你個鋪頭不嬲都係喺呢度啊，喺佐敦。
我以前上海街，
哦，
好
少地方做啲好嘅糕點，係。
停咗8年咧，做上海再玩翻做唔啱，做我个女话我哋做糕咁好食，人哋出边食唔到我嘅糕，教客呢一直都追我，成日都打电话食唔到你嗰啲糕啊，吓我哋支持你啊，但系我哋已经年纪大啦，佢话唔怕啦，佢出嚟帮手。
So Mrs. Fong, she's from Chiu Chau, and she actually have been making, we call it gou, for many, many years. And it's great to come to her store and see the different type of gou she have.
呢個馬豆，青橙馬豆，係啦係啦，仲要龍眼紅棗。
同埋黃糖糕、白糖糕，黃糖糕、白糖。係啊，俾我啲同事試下。我細個成日睇我阿媽做，都覺得好食。初初係先心四種，白糖糕都最先嚟嘅。以前鄉下咧好中意白糖糕咧，蒸嗰啲法果擺曬，後尾慢慢逐樣佢發明出啊，全部劑嚟嘅。 下都覺得好開心啊！哇，做得咁好食啊！
蓮子桂花啦，要唔係？
係。
咁呢啲打包嘅。
哦哦。
咁啊，呢個盤仔糕我就拎住食。
好。
好。多謝曬。
Thank you.
等一下，好啦，唔使啦，好啦，得啦，拜拜。
So I'm eating a very classic Hong Kong sweet dessert. This is like bu zai go. Bu zai is like a small bowl, and then this brown color has come from brown sugar. And I love the texture. It's really, really soft. It's not too sweet, and then you have a bit of the texture of the red bean. It just reminds me of my childhood favorite sweet street food.
要零料，我唔慳錢嚟㗎。我覺得真材實料又有益。係咪？又我哋又用心嚟做又好食，用心嚟做唔用心做唔到明。
This street vendor start learning their skills at such a young age, much younger than most regular chefs, and that really comes through in their food.
我就整咗四十幾年咯，我十零歲已經開始，我每一日都要成千隻噶。
There's puff pastry and there's like cookie-based pastry. My favorite egg tart, 100% puff pastry egg tart because it has such a satisfying texture because it's flaky, you know, and then you have the soft, just cooked egg custard inside.
水皮係佔好緊要，嗰個水皮猜得靚，因為你大個軟大個硬都會影響個蛋撻。蛋漿就係最緊要係乜嘢咧？因為個份量係最緊要啦。
To be able to make that puff pastry puff is one skill, and then to be able to cook the puff pastry without the egg custard being overcooked, or the other way around, the egg custard is just cooked and the puff pastry is not cooked enough. That's why the puff pastry egg tart is the best.
咁樣係為之咧，最靚嘅蛋撻啦！出咗爐十分鐘之後咧，啲蛋撻係暖暖地係最好食嘅時候啦。啊，一啖蛋漿啊，一啖皮咁樣咧，捱啱啱暖暖地嗰陣時係最脆口同埋最好食。
試下啲蛋撻，
酥皮
係
正，
係啊，你細個好中意食蛋撻啊，我哋都中意啊嘛，所以特登買啲酥皮。
I always would just get half a dozen, because family they would eat maybe one or two, and then I'll just have the rest myself.
中食糖。
Hello，Hello，
想食乜嘢？
哇，你啲魚蛋好似好吸引喎！
係啊，我哋呢啲魚蛋買咗幾廿年嘅都係。
我仲特登過嚟呢度食你個臭豆腐添。
係啊，唔緊要，我哋啲豆腐都好食㗎。
哦，因為我自己好中意食臭豆腐，我可唔可以同你嗌兩粒臭豆腐同埋一串辣嘅魚蛋啊？
好啊，冇問題。
Stinky tofu basically means it's fermented tofu, kind of like cheese, you know. You either like it or you don't like it, like blue cheese and durian.
Thank you. Mmm, it's so sweet. It's so sweet. Now, do you think there will be more small places to sell tofu?
Of course, because...炸臭豆腐都會有啲唔好嘅味道出嚟，即係唔係個個接受到啊嘛。
但係中意食嗰啲好似我咁就好中意食嘅，越臭越好。
咁當然啦。
我以前記得我細個嗰時咧，最中意係加翻呢個醬，呢個甜醬。
係啊。
我等人咬一啖先。
你試下。
我等唔切啦，我。
你試下。
哇，好脆啊！
係啊，新鮮炸起好係香口嘅。
好脆，同埋佢裏邊。好彈啊，彈彈地啊，嗯，
我認為啦，嗰陣我自己認為最好嘅臭豆腐係要外脆內軟咯，
係啊，
入邊係要有嗰個有少少
哇嚇
豆腐嗰種軟滑嘅口感，我覺得係最好。
嗯，哇！我好耐冇食過嗰個原味嘅炸出嚟，啱啱炸出嚟嘅臭豆腐。
I grew up eating this, and they would fry it right in front of you. And from like the moment you get out of the car, you smell this, and you just follow the smell, and you will find this tofu.
Even if you don't know where the store, you can probably, from the smell, you can find the store.
以前嘅臭豆腐會再會整得臭啲，
係，
因為以前就真係需要揾食咧，佢冇所謂噶嘛，最緊要係幾條街遠。都可以聞到嗰個臭豆腐味，係啦，咁樣可以吸引多啲客人嚟買。但係依家真係嘅，我哋都喺臭與唔影響到人嗰個之間要攞到個平衡點咯，係啊。
哦，即係又唔可以太臭，
係啦，但係唔可以唔臭，係啊，個平衡點要攞得好咯。
There aren't many places left in Hong Kong doing stinky tofu, but it is a culture in Hong Kong, and I don't think it's going to disappear because there's a big percentage of Hong Kong people that would love to eat it. So what we're trying to do is to let our guests and diners know that something as simple as this can be elevated into something elegant.
I
think for places like Gong Wo, it has been there for many, many years and has been passed down generation and generation. I think that is the same for the customer. You know, my dad would be going there when he's a kid, and then when he have kids, which is me, he'll bring me there.
你多咗好多新嘢喎。我一定會嗌一個熱嘅豆腐花啦，腸粉啦。咁同埋你有咩介紹啊？
你可以試下呢個豆腐雪糕啊，都好多人中意食。
好啊，好啊。咁我會嗌一個豆腐雪糕。
好啊，好啊。咁你等我一陣。
唔該曬。
喂，
唔該曬。
俾咗呢幾樣你先。
嗱，
呢個蝦米丸，呢個。腸粉啊，呢個熱嘅豆腐花，好，慢慢食啊！
唔該唔該，
好似細細個咁啊！食邊個好咧？嚟一個先。
This is what I grew up eating a lot in Hong Kong. There's many different types of 腸粉. You just add whatever toppings that you like. So this one have the soy sauce, very good sesame flavor, sesame paste, sweet sauce.And just light and filling, so that's great for the morning.
Cheung Fan is such a great street food to try if you're visiting from overseas. Soft rice rolls and delicious sauces. It's hard to find anyone who doesn't love Cheung Fan. It is so comforting, and that's why we have a version on the menu at Holy Folk.
咦，差唔多食曬啦喎。
係啊
，OK 啊，
好好食啊。
喂，試埋呢個啊，呢個豆腐雪糕好食㗎，好多人試。
Rene create a lot of different things as compared to maybe when I went 10 years ago. I'm glad to see her enjoying but also pushing the business forward.
好少見，例如咁多年歷史傳人係女性啦。對你嚟講有冇咩難處啊？
我諗開頭會難啲嘅，即係好似我哋咁樣，其實都係一個即係好多年歷史嘅一間。即係豆品廠咁樣，你要一路帶住佢前進，去到試好多新嘅嘢咧。但係你依家係帶住一隊人一齊去試啊嘛。咁所以當中我諗有好多個溝通啊。
I think running Gong Wo is definitely harder than what I imagined at the beginning. That's why I think it's very important we as a family we can share all the workload and the burden together.
好乜嘢啊雪糕？好 refreshing。因為應該都會。為我帶嚟一啲靈感。好高興認識你，
好，下次再嚟啊！
加油，繼續努力啊！好，買豆漿。呢間係舊鋪啊。Hello，Hello。哇，仲喺度啊！間舊鋪，
係啊係啊，
好耐冇見，好耐冇翻嚟。好，我買啲豆漿翻去試下。咁啊，我要個無糖啊。
無糖好啊。
係啦，我要個無糖。同埋我想試埋嗰個咧，杞子龍眼粉，係啊係。
呢個龍眼粉。
好啊好啊好啊。
呢個好飲嘅。
我翻去可能試個甜品，靈感啊。好。
For me, this kind of store represent what Hong Kong people is like. They're just really hardworking. They will continue to work.Not because now they have been making a living, because the customer, they have memory, they want to go there, they want to visit, they want to bring their kids. There's a phrase I go back to quite often in Hong Kong, it's called Yang Cheng Mei. I think this is almost the flavor of the human connection.
加油啊，你要努力，我一齊嚟探你。
有時間多啲翻嚟啊。
好啊，好啊。Hello. 喂，買咗啲嘢過嚟食啊，試下。
食下啲
今日我去掃街啊，喺佐敦買翻嚟噶，你試下，覺得點啊？
幾懷舊啊，幾傳統，個口感幾好。
不会太甜。
So after the soul guide today, there's two dishes that I got inspired from. One is Mrs. Fong, the goji berry and dates, the longan flavor. The other one would be going to Gong Wo, trying the Cheung Fan XO sauce shrimp ball. The Cheung Fan brings a lot of memory because that is like classic way we eat it. So for the Cheung Fan, I want to do something that have a bit of the contrast in texture.
A big part of the success of Wings since the opening was connecting people's Hong Kong memories and thoughts through fine dining point of view. Ultimately, it's not about doing it for the sake of doing it. It's doing it because I originally love the taste of this particular food, and I know that my guests would too. When I sat here one day, I said, I really want to use stinky tofu. I enjoy it a lot, and I really want my guests to enjoy it. But how do we serve something that you can get on the streets of Mong Kok, but get people to pay for it and be elegant enough to be in this fine dining establishment? And so in this case, is a combination of fried stinky tofu and prawn toast. It's like the two authentic golden bricks combined together. It's like a stinky tofu and prawn toast baby. We're just shaping this into the perfect little brick, right? So you have the toast on the bottom, as you can see. And now lastly, I'm gonna take this beautiful piece of coriander. It's important for the tofu and the shrimp to be in good ratio. You can smell already from here.
So basically now, the wok is really hot. And then at this stage, I don't want to move the wok too much because I just want to get the crispy layer of the Cheung Fan. And then what we do here is wok fry with a lot of different type of vegetables. And a lot of the wok hay goes into the Cheung Fan.
So this is red onion, chili, and spring onion.
And here we pair with our house-made XO sauce. And XO sauce is obviously one of the most famous sauce in Cantonese cuisine because it's created by a chef in Hong Kong. Just get a bit of umami flavor, a little bit of spiciness. And then when finished, we put a bit of the sesame seeds.
So for here, we have an XO sauce stir-fried Cheung Fan. And then on top, we have the sesame, which really reminds me of the Cheung Fan we have this morning. This is a comfort food going into the exciting zone with some chili.
So our version is very different from the street food or the breakfast version, but it suits our holy folk dining because you can taste a lot of the local flavor, XO sauce and sesame and Cheung Fan in one dish. Delicious.
We're going to eat Gai Daan Jai. Do you want some Gai Daan Jai? Yes? Mommy, hold you.
Okay, jump.
Okay, which one do you like?
Cheese.
Okay,
I think in the past 5 years, I've seen growing number of young people coming to Central Post. They try to set up their own cafe, and also Thai or Malaysian, Pakistani. This all makes like Central Post change a lot. It becomes a more diverse society.
Okay, Phoebe, 攞雞蛋仔得啦。
My daughter is 3 years old. I also hope she would love kitchen, enjoying like cooking food. I think it's a great lesson for kids.
It's a very thick piece of toast, with raw shrimp inside. So you gotta make sure the temperature of the oil is correct so the bread doesn't burn before the actual toast is cooked.
So this is a combination of two traditional things, and this is what we do at Wing, is to create dishes based on something traditional, but creating our own DNA in it.
The texture of the fermented tofu, it's soft, but also have a resistance, and it goes so well with the bounciness of the shrimp. Really good.
We want you to have this stinky tofu and feel it the moment you cut into it, and it's like, okay, that's stinky tofu, absolutely. Sometimes a guest will come in and order this and say, oh, I wish it was stronger, but I don't want you to smell it from like the other side of the restaurant. So the fermentation is toned down a bit. When you eat it, you feel it a little bit, but then when you're done, it goes away. So that's the spicy version. And now I'm gonna taste the sweet miso sauce, Chinese miso. Growing up as a kid, I didn't really like too much spicy, so I would put more of the sweet sauce, more than a spicy one, when I was 5 years old. They're both really, really good, but the sweet one immediately was like a memory from years ago. So good, so good. I'm gonna have one more bite. I have a platform here in my restaurant that is attracting a lot of younger generation. I feel like it is perhaps my duty and responsibility to make sure that this is a memory and a flavor that will always be here as a part of Hong Kong, absolutely.
So this is the version of, you know, like very traditional dessert, longan, dates, goji berry. And I thought it would be really good to make it like into like a granita. Gong Mo and Mrs. Fong, they both use, you know, the goji berry and dates, the longan flavor. One is a drink, one is a gold. Kind of the gold flavor, we do it in a tapioca pearl, we soak it in a date syrup, goji berry, and then some white fungus, which is also a classic combination. And then on top, we do a tofu sorbet, finished with a bit of the osmanthus. It's very light and refreshing. Now we make it into a granita version. It adds another layer of flavor and memory. And the tofu sorbet just bind everything together, give it a bit of velocity. You know, tofu sorbet is something that is very, you know, I think unique to Hong Kong. And this is also one of my dad's favorite desserts. I think the appetite for street food is gonna be always there, no matter if it's local or tourist, because I think it's part of the culture. So be adventurous, be open-minded. So if you go to a shop and you see a long queue, give it a go.
The spirit in Hong Kong has always been about food. In a sense of palate, in a sense of memory, maybe I'm not here to recreate a fishball. Maybe I'm not pushing the cart. Maybe I'm not doing a casual restaurant as such, but absolutely street food has made me who I am and also a person who is very proud of being from Hong Kong.
I think Hong Kong people are very careful to do business.
He never tells me in front of me, but I knew that from other friends. He is very pleased with his daughter, keep running the business. And also, he see growing number of people coming to our shop from overseas to try our tofu. That is something really out of his mind that would happen in his life.
If my son is willing to do it, of course I'm happy. 呢一個豆品行業一路咁樣盛存落去咯。